I speak like a child. I look like a child through dancing eyes. I wish more for you. I
am here for you. Good morning. Happy New Year, sons and daughters of Abraham, and to the rest of the world, good morning. I have a delightful and simple, like a child, meditation this morning, and a rejoicing one. 1 Corinthians 1:27. But God hath chosen the foolish things of the world to confound the wise. And God hath chosen the weak things of the world to confound the things which are mighty. This immediately sent my mind and soul spinning in a multitude of directions. I was thinking about this sort of confluence of ideas and the... Basically how ideas in this day and age are being generated so fast and so furiously that the accumulation of knowledge and breakthroughs and stuff are exponentially progressing at a greater and greater speed. And yet I genuinely feel that much of the knowledge we are accumulating is ultimately trivial, that we are all becoming masters of the trivial. I've long enjoyed whooping booty at Trivial Pursuit and Jeopardy. And having character actors on the tip of my tongue. But I think it's important to know that all the wisdom of the wise is often confounded by the most basic questions, the first questions we all learn to ask. I often have been thinking lately that the most important one is why. Ask why to almost anything. Kids do it all the time. Like a child. Think like a child today. Think like a child in this new year. I think so much of what we do is built up aware of this wisdom and this wisdom and this wisdom and this wisdom. I know I chase it. I chase wisdom around and little T truths and big T truths, and it gives me this certainly a sense of doing what is right. And but to be like a child in his hands is our ultimate purpose. We can clamor and decide and elucidate and discover all that we can discover. Still, we are often troubled. We are all still troubled by the most basic of questions. Who, what, when, where, why? Who are we? Who are we really? You know? Oh, well, we're a collection of, cells and atoms that collided together and progressed this point, and here we are. Okay. Yeah, but who are we really? And to answer like a child, we're children of God. What is going on? Well, entropy is, law of entropy is sort of the nature of all things, and things are destroying, and the universe might be slowly decaying, but oh, you know what? Wait, no, it might actually be continually expanding and being created, and what really? What's going on? We are broken. Why is the entropy? Because we are broken and this world is broken. Why are people shifty shell? Why do we seek all these things to fill our hunger that will not? The world is broken and we are broken and we are in enmity to God from the day we are born. Even before, perhaps. I don't know. When? Well, you know, it's either 2010 or 5751, right? Or 500, billion years that we've been rolling around here in some form or another. But what's the child's answer to when? Now. Now. Right now, between you and I, in this moment, this is where we are. This is when we are. and the time is now to enter in. Happy New Year. Enter into who you can be and who you were always meant to be. Things are broken and they can be fixed. Where are we? It's kind of the what, isn't it? Huh? I kind of did that with what, didn't I? Well, whatever. These are improvised. Where are we? We are in this broken world. And we are also in God's hands. If we so, our cup can choose. Even a little bit, isn't it? But it almost doesn't matter. Seek and ye shall find. Repent and ye shall obey. And why? Most important question of all. Because we choose darkness every day. We choose enmity to God in everything that we do. Almost every second, we have those choices. And we're constantly choosing ourselves, are we not? We're constantly choosing selfishly. And if we're doing okay, then someone around us, I guarantee, is choosing selfishly. Because it really is just a simple, simple choice. Ourselves. Are we ourselves, or are we His? Do we remain enmity and under the burden of it for all that we have done, thought, been, that is contrary to the light and glory of His name? Or are we His, holy and truly His? We are broken. He can mend us. We are ruptured. His rapture is the solution for our rupture. Like a child, I hope you think and dream and believe and move this new year, my pretties, my beloveds. I hope I have enough time. I'm actually not looking at the appropriate window to know. But pray with me, if you would, this prayer of repentance, and may it change your entire life like a child. Psalm 51. Have mercy upon me according to your kindness, according to the multitude of your tender mercies. Blot my transgression, wash me from my iniquity, and cleanse me from my sin. I acknowledge my transgressions, and my sin is always before me. Against you, you only have I sinned, and done this evil in your sight. You may be found just when you speak, just when you judge. Behold, brought forth in iniquity, and in sin this evening. Behold, you desire truth in the inward parts, and in the hidden part you will make no wisdom. Purge me with hyssop, and I shall be clean. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. Make me hear joy and gladness. Bones you have broken, may rejoice. Hide your face my sins, and blot out my iniquities. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a steadfast spirit within me. Do not come your presence, and do not your Holy Spirit from me. Restore to me the of your salvation, and uphold me by your generous spirit. Then I will teach transgressors your ways, and sinners converted to you. Deliver me from the guilt of bloodshed, O God, the God of my salvation, and my tongue shall sing aloud of your righteousness. O Lord, open lips, and my mouth shall show forth these. For you did not desire sacrifice, or give it. You did not delight in burnt offering. The sacrifices of God, a broken spirit, a broken and a contrite heart. Thee, God, you will not despise. In the name of Yeshua, blood given to save you, I say peace be unto you, and I say amen, and Selah.